Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo into a white chalk wall drawing. I provided this brick wall background for you to download. Its link is located in my video's description or project files. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to make into a chalk drawing. The first step is to make a selection around your subject so we can separate it from its background. There are many ways to do this, and your choice should depend on the characteristics of your photo. For this example, I'll use the magic wand tool since the background is a solid color. If you're using this tool as well, make sure contiguous is checked. Click outside the subject. To include areas within the selection, go to those areas and press and hold Shift as you click on them. To make sure you selected all of your subject, press Q to see the selection as a quick mask. Then press Q again to revert it back into a selection. When you're happy with it, invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut the subject from its background and copy it to its own layer. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can add filters non-destructively, as well as change the subject if we want to without having to redo all the effects. Hide the background and click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. You know a layer is a smart object if this icon is at the lower right corner of its thumbnail. If your photo has a lot of shadows, you can brighten them and bring out their detail by going to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. I'll increase the shadows amount to 100% and click OK. We want to make the foreground and background colors white and black respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard to make them black and white, and then press X to invert them. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Photocopy. I'll make the detail 2 and the darkness 50. However, feel free to experiment with the amounts. You can always adjust them later since they're being applied to a smart object. We want to make a new layer below the active layer. To do this, Ctrl-click or Command-click on the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, and since black is your background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Shift-click on the top layer to add it to the highlighted layers. Click the icon at the upper right corner and convert these layers into one smart object. Press V to open your Move tool and drag it up onto the tab of the brick background. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down onto the background, then release. Pressing Shift kept your subject centered. Change its blend mode to either screen or lighter color. To make it larger or smaller, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a top corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it out or in. To reposition it, go inside the transform and drag it. When you're happy with its size and position, press Enter or Return. Next, I'll show you how to clean up your drawing by hiding unwanted lines and spots. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. The hardness should be 100%, as well as the opacity. Then press Enter or Return. To make your pencil larger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Carefully draw over those areas of your image that you'd like to clean up. You're actually drawing over the layer mask, which is masking out those areas. Next, we'll add a chalk-like texture to the drawing. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Tick Gaussian, and drag the slider to an amount that looks good to you. I'll drag it to approximately 70%, then click OK. Next, we'll widen the chalk outline surrounding your subject. Double-click the Smart Object to open it. Click the FX icon, and click Stroke. Click the color box, and pick White. Then, click OK. Make the size 2 pixels, the position either center or inside, and the blend mode, dissolve. Reduce its opacity to 60%, then click OK. Close the Smart Object tab, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Your drawing is now updated with a wider outline. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.